Alright, I gotta do one more try. I gotta do one more goddamn try. And we're gonna start out exactly like we did the first time. I'm going to get quad shot out the goddamn gate. And not fucking mom's panties or whatever the hell they're called. Mom's underwear. Fucking range up. Anybody gives a shit about range up? Oh, this is an annoying first room to get just because of the sheer amount of time it's gonna take me to fucking get through it. And I should never have been hit, but I did get hit because I am stupid. Come on, man, I moved out of the- whatever. It's continuing exercise and I'll take that frustration. This allows me to unlock anything on it that has a lock on this floor. So, provided I actually find something with a lock, it'll have been worth it. If I don't find anything with a lock, then that'll be just fantastic. I won't be mad at all. I won't consider it a prevailing sign that Binding of Isaac is seen fit to make my life hell. The game is not satisfied. It's not fulfilled by just making Isaac go through hell. It's gotta make me go through hell too. Fucker. It's not even fun! I'm done. That was my one run. It's gonna define the greatness that could have been possible. The grand potential for my life was in that goddamn. Actually, okay, you know what? Let's just see. I was talking shit about this. I have a full heart in here, right? Yeah, I do. You bitch. You stupid fucker. You massive fuckface. Go fuck yourself. See, that's why those things are bullshit. That was what, 5 hearts? 5 hearts I just gave away. And it did not give that shit to me. On the first floor, it's expecting you to give more than 5 hearts. I'm gonna go back there because I'm stubborn and I refuse to lose to that bitch. My god, never mind, I'm not gonna. Oh, would you go away? This is actually kind of terrible. Shit. I didn't even. Okay. Oh, we're starting off with another boring ass. Can I do something good? Anything good? I'm telling you. I mean, granted, having one run out of what is this, the fourth? One run that looked like it did out of 4, and I just ruined it thanks to ignorance. That's kind of what you can generally expect out of roguelikes. You know, like, there are so many items, not all of them can be fucking amazing, fantastic, game-breaking items. Occasionally you're gonna get shitty ones. And more often than not, you're gonna get shitty ones. That actually is one thing I have to give Risk of Rain. There's never really an item that I'm just like, ah, damn it, that's how useless is that? There are some fairly, you know, kind of the kind of power-ups that I'm just completely ambivalent to. Like, I don't care about them. They're nothing to me. They mean nothing to me. But it's still not like, ah, kind of a deal. Like, whereas with Binding of Isaac, I feel like half the items in this game, I just see them. And I'm just like, well, what a waste of an eye. I guess it also has a lot to do with the fact that there's a lot fewer item availability places where you can actually get items. I just wanted to test that out to see what it would do. Granted, it's a little hard, because that would never have, that would never have hit had the boss not stood there and spawned that thing. That's not terrible. Speed, can't ever really complain about speed up. It's just in general, when you're first starting out, the one thing you really truly want is... Oh, cool. That's nice. Pretty much the prevailing desire for an item is something that's going to boost your damage output. Anything is going to boost your damage output, because you do not start out with fantastic... stuff. That's pretty useful, because I believe this dude's permanent. I think he sticks around and just does damage to anything that comes near me. That's a pretty nice effect to get for a pill. If I get hit, it's because I'm looking for tinted rocks instead of paying attention to what the fuck's coming after me! Thank you, Fly. Fly just saved me from taking damage. Or at least I'm pretty sure the Fly just saved me from taking damage. I'm pretty sure it hit him and kind of knocked him away. That's cool. I will not take damage from spikes anymore. Not sure. I believe this goes away when you leave a room. I'll wait until I'm actually in a room with enemies to use it. Is that thing doing the opposite of what I'm doing? No. Why the hell is it just chilling in the fucking corner then? And why am I taking goddamn damage? I'm so terrible! Shit. We're okay. We're perfectly fine. I wasn't worried for a second. Well then. Bring it on, Bomberman. I'm in an exitless corner. Good thing you didn't keep on coming, because I had no way out at that point. Hope I can get past that. I don't give a shit about that. I am going to pause on Joker. I'll use that card on the next, I didn't get, man. That's sad. I didn't get another buddy. I was hoping I might get a, this is gonna take forever. Actually, you know what? Once he launches himself into the air, which will happen eventually, I'm gonna drop a bomb. Oops. That was good, still worked. I thought the pause was long enough that he was gonna do that. Eventually, he's gonna do something where he doesn't just, like, do the short hop. He does a super jump. Let's use fighting game terminology to describe Binding of Isaac. This is taking so damn long, I might just cut my own eyes out. The pretty fly just absorbed that. I feel like that should have hit me, but it's also, it's kind of weird. Like, sometimes it's difficult to tell the trajectory that shots have in this game. So I don't know if that just missed me or if the fly managed to grab it and make it not happen. So let's grab this for, oh, that's useful. Good, 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 good. I like that shit. So let's use this. And oops. Well, we done wasted the shit out of that. Although I'm pretty sure I didn't see anything that I don't think I wanted anything that was there anyway. But if I had, let's just say, if my ass had seen Brimstone and I accidentally walked out of the room like that, I probably would have. I know I kind of make some jokes about, you know, throwing myself off a building, doing various self-harm activities and such. But I would never actually follow through with them. I have no interest. I don't like pain. Not my favorite thing in the world, so I would never actually follow through on any of that shit. However, if I lost something like Brimstone to a dumbass mistake like that, I would seriously consider it. It wouldn't be a joke. It would be, let me just go grab a knife and stare at it for a while and see whether or not it's worth it at this point, because it just might be. Because as we all know, self-harm over a video game is extremely logical. Not at all a ridiculous overreaction to occasions that have occurred. And definitely deserved. Justified. It's a TV show I need to look into. Do you guys watch that? Justified. I see a lot of previews for it because it's on. I see a lot of previews for it because of Sons of Anarchy, which is now over, so I will no longer be seeing previews for it. But, yeah, that's where I saw a lot of them. I should look into it. But I figured, hey, why not ask for opinions and see if anybody. Any of my three viewers actually watch that. Man, I got so excited. I keep forgetting to mention this. I got so excited for a second. I thought that somehow, some way, one of my videos had blown the fuck up. Because I looked at my Creator Studio section of YouTube. And it said 3K subscribers. And I was like, holy shit. Yesterday I was barely at 2,500. Oh my god, what's happening? Is this it? Is this my moment? Am I going to have a real, like, humongous millions and zillions and trillions of people watching my show now? Is that what's gonna go down? And, because obviously that's the logical, oh my god. Well, damn it, I didn't want to get hit there. I might have gotten a devil room if I had not gotten hit. We already went to the devil room here, didn't we? This is the one where he accidentally jolted out of it, so it was kind of irrelevant because we didn't want anything there anyway. But yeah, it turns out YouTube just rounds up. So I saw 3K and thought, like, holy shit, I have 3K subscribers now. What the fuck happened? Like, which video did it? What am I gonna have to start playing more? But no, it just I hit 2,500 and it rounded up to 3K. Thanks, YouTube, you fuckers. Yeah, I'll grab those. That was definitely worth it. That less worth it, but it wasn't a bad thing, so I can't complain. Now I can complain. Fuck! Damn, those dudes shoot too fast. Oh shit. Have I found? I have not found. I was looking to see if I had found the upgrade room. I'm already out of it. I was in it for a little bit. When I first started, I was good. I was grand. But as time goes on, my mind has proceeded to devolve into the sleepless incompetence that it is known for. And so now I can't even remember what rooms I visited and which one I haven't. It's kind of the same as when I'm working. Like, I will remember everything about the first, like, when if I play a game like this, and let's say I do, like, 5 runs or something like that. I will remember everything down to the most minute details of the very first run. Like, shit that seems entirely irrelevant, I'll remember it. And then, after that first run, the second one I start to kind of miss a couple. I start to miss some things. I haven't gotten anything particularly amazing, but just everything that's like, I'm kind of just getting something of everything so far. So it's like, it's nothing fantastic, it's nothing to write home about, but it's very solid overall. So I really can't complain about this run. This is actually quite nice, because Shield of Tears are actually amazing against Mom's Heart. Because Mom's Heart basically, like, what her biggest, the biggest thing she does is basically send a bullet hell at you. Shield of Tears basically nullify any shots that hit them. So I pretty much just have to stand still and keep shooting in one direction. I'm basically invulnerable to Mom's Heart with these. So the Shield of Tears are very, very useful. That is definitely not an upgrade that you can really underestimate. Oh, cool. See, like that. Like, now Greed poses absolutely zero threat to me. Well, of course, until he changes angle just perfectly enough. But nor normally, under circumstances that were not designed solely to make a damn fool out of me, yay, had to be one of the two. I should have figured it. Ooh, what is this? Okay, well, that's not good. Did I just... Oh, okay. So it doesn't give me something different every single time I move? Is that what's going on here? No, I'm back to normal. So I see the dead bird. I don't actually know what that growth does, though. The bird... So I'm mad again now. No, I still have all that shit. So I still have all the upgrades that I got, but none of them are actually in effect as far as I can tell. This just sucks. I had that amazing run the first time around, and I fuck it all up because I wasn't sure which dice roll that was. And now, again, I have a very, very respectable run. Nothing particularly amazing, but still quite good. And now, like, look at my damage output. My damage output sucks balls right now. If I had my normal one without the missing number, they would have died long ago. Okay, well, at least we got a devil room. Oh shit. I will definitely take the pentagram, and I will definitely take the goat's head. The question is, do these upgrades stick around? Do they still stay in effect after getting that item? Does that item just scramble everything I have at the moment? You know, what happens? No, okay, yeah. So it looks like every... Ooh. Okay, yeah, that's actually useful. I can most definitely use that. Whoa! Okay, never mind, I don't like this. I was not expecting the rebound effect. So yeah, so that item just scrambles me every single floor, which I'm really... I mean, like I kind of said, if... Yeah, whatever. When it comes to games like this, when the majority of items suck, and there's just, you know, there's a few extremely good ones, a few very good ones, and then some that are, you know, okay, but nothing really to write home about. Having any kind of random reroll effect when you have something that's already good is just, it's terrible. You definitely do not want it in a game like this. But I fucking got it. And now I got it twice. When I finally, like I said, that was built, it was, like, slowly building. It wasn't just, like, the first run where I immediately out of the gate get this amazing fucking item that basically almost guarantees that I'm gonna win. But it was all stuff that was useful, so it was all adding up. Alright, I'll grab Mom's coin first. Oh, cool. I don't know what gave me that, but I'll take it. Did that go down? That's gone down. I had it at 216, didn't I? I wonder why that went down. I'll grab a second fly. Balls of Steel's useful. Luck Up is obviously very useful. I don't know why I just gave away the fifth. I should have kept 15. So it looks like every single floor I get scrambled. Have I found the upgrade? No, I have not. See, again, everything's blending together in my mind. I didn't even finish that, actually. I scrambled myself before. So, like, I always remember everything about the first run. And then everything that happens afterwards, I don't really remember that well. And eventually it gets to a point where I'm just like, I'm second guessing everything I do, or like every memory I have. So like, it's the same thing when I work. I go into stores, and the first store I work, I remember everything about it. I know exactly what the store has, what the store needs, what the store doesn't have, etc., etc. And then I get to a second store, and then stuff starts blending together a little bit. Like, okay, wait, am I remembering this properly for this store, or was the last store that had that? And then it just compounds itself every time I go to a new store. Shit. I almost shot him when he was right on top of me. That would have been bad. I've learned my lesson to keep my damn distance. Shit, so I have to charge. Okay. See, that's something. Pretty much every single version of the charge shot that you can get, I would never willingly take those. I really just don't like them in general. I feel like you have better damage potential when you don't have to charge, when you can just rapid fire. And so if I had known what that was, I would not have taken it. Just like, I mean, obviously that wasn't... it's quite, like, in this situation, for this kind of shot, I guess, you know, to say it's situationally useful would probably be the most accurate way to put it. What did I get? Eh. May as well take it. It gives decent damage. What are we going to get rolled as on the next floor? Please give me something particularly amazing and take away the charge shot. Oh, that's actually quite... Oh, shit. It was quite good until I saw the exploding brain. Fuck! And I immediately blow myself up. Isn't that... Hey, it's actually giving me random health. Too, like, see, I gained a heart right there? I wonder if that means it could take it away. I'd assume so. Can't really see why it wouldn't. If it doesn't, that means eventually I'm gonna be able to, Oh shit, my bad. I forgot this room had all spikes. Oh! What am I talking about? I don't have to give a shit about spikes. So your items, your usable items and your passive items don't actually have... Missing number does not affect that at all. Kuno? We're good. Nothing to be scared of. Would you just die? Thank you. Oh wow, this dude's basically just gonna die from getting bodied by these things. Oops. And right as I say that, oh, I have a shield! So every single time, basically, every time you move, I can take one hit per room. Which is actually gonna be particularly amazing with Bob's brain. It basically means I can make one mistake with Bob's brain and not really be punished for it. Oh, why not? I probably should have saved that for a room that was more occupied, whatever. No, yes, that went well. Oops. Thought I was gonna get hit. Got lucky. No! You go away! Oh, did I just completely skip the upgrade room? I just completely skipped the upgrade room. I'm gonna get to 225 and see if that unlocks any... Fuck you. Fine. Yeah, I'll grab that. I believe. I don't even know, like, if I'm actually sure on what. Even the items that I've gotten a fairly decent amount of time, I still don't even know if I'm absolutely sure that I know what they do. Why do I keep dodging those spikes? But I'm. Actually, you know what? Yeah, fuck that. Fuck those things. Yeah, I should have saved it for this room. But I believe the Gimp mask. Oops, oops, oops. Go the fuck away! does that. Whenever you get hit, it gives you a potential for money. Fuck, I had no real way out of that. Alright, so I'm doing absolutely zero goddamn damage here. Just super fun. Oh. I thought I had moved far enough away. Instead, the foot came down behind me. Yeah, I'm doing no damn damage here. Alright, I gotta make sure that happens. I'm taking so much damage here. I should actually try and kind of stand around and see if these, my rotating... my little zoo here. Oh, I didn't get the boss rush room. How sad. How much time did that take me? Oh, barely. I think you have to, I believe you have to beat it in another 20 minutes, so I... Huh? I became Lord of the Flies. How cool. Oh, fuck. I have another charge shot. What is that? Oh, my God. This is terrible. My life sucks right now. Oh, never mind. I think my entourage is actually going to be doing the majority of my damage here. Because my current shots ain't going to be doing shit. Oh, actually, you know what? Is that... No, that's not it. Is it? Maybe it is. Let's see, does it drag it? No, it doesn't. I thought that might have been magnetism. In that, my shots, whenever I fired anything, it would actually drag the opponents into the shots. And so basically, I didn't even know, you, fuck you. I wouldn't really have to worry about aiming. It would just, you know, I'd let them out. But that is, this is what this does. Does not magnetic shots, but I am just magnetic, and I drag items to me. So why did I draw? Oh! Mom's purse effect got changed into something else. Sure, I'll use that. Oh, do I flight right now? I flight right now. Didn't even realize. Oh, shit, 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 stupid. Oh, my bad. I thought that was an enemy for some reason. See, I'm actually not doing too terribly here. This is... Thanks to the entourage, I'm doing pretty decently. The only problem is that I'm slow as hell right now. That would be my only oops. I forgot those versions explode when you kill them. Should have saved that balls of steel. Oh, that won't hurt me. See, now the problem is I've gotten used to the other, what I had the floor before, so I keep thinking, oh, I got a shield, I can take one hit, I don't really need to be that terribly careful about it, when yes I do. Just like in this floor, I'm gonna get used to having flight. Then on the next floor I won't anymore. It'll make me sad. Not like being sad. Oopsie, I had no reason to unlock that shit. I had no reason to avoid the damn spikes. I'm being a fucking moron. Alright, which boss are we gonna draw first? I'm gonna call Carnage. Nope. Blastocyst. This may actually take a while. Never mind. That dude does ridiculous fucking damage. Look at his output. That dude's fucking going in. See, but now it doesn't even matter. Like, I look at upgrades, I'm like, oh, cool, I like that upgrade. I know that upgrade does pretty decently. But holy Jesus. This looks interesting. I'm liking this. Not everything is bad here. That's a good floor to get something particularly amazing. Oh, my bad. Let's see if maybe that's a secret room. That is a hint. Nope. Oh, I don't have to worry about the spikes. I still got my little calloused feet. My calloused footies. Chill. Oh, wait, do I fly still? Ooh, I do. Don't gotta worry about that. Oh, they got close. I probably should have been hit there. Wow, I'm gonna do ridiculous damage to these guys. Yeah. Because each segment of their body counts as a different hittable object. They all have their own health. So I'm hitting every single damn one of them, doing ridiculous damage. Ooh. This is crazy. I really like this right now. I wish I actually knew specifically what all these upgrades were. So let's see if this is the secret room right around here. Damn. Fine, I don't know shit. Does that persist? No, it does not. I was wondering if that persisted throughout the entire stage. But nope, that shit does wear out. This is definitely a very good... I got no complaints about this right now. Other than the fact that I'm a moron and got hit by that, which I am, and I never should have. Whoa. I was not prepared for that. Every time I've actually ever fought that enemy, I've always killed it before he's ever attacked, so I didn't know that's what he did. So I guess that's one indication that this layout isn't amazing. Like, it's good, I definitely have no complaints, but it's not, like, anything hugely special. Is that I really don't have the type of damage output that I would typically have. Wait, did that open that up? That's weird. Why wouldn't that one have an exit? That's odd. Maybe that's why. Because it was a sloth room and you can only access that through the main door. It's a feature of those boss fights. So let's go fight Mom's Heart. It lives, that's what it's called. Although it still has Mom's voice, which is a little weird. Oh, damn. See, this is where Shielded's actually... I think I'm good here. Like, I think the flies are gonna basically handle everything around me. I don't have to worry about I'm not getting hit. Oh shit, I gotta worry about that. Flies ain't gonna save me from that shit. Okay, so I believe... Well, actually, I'm gonna go there yet. Oh, never mind. So going down leads me to Shield, so I don't know where this leads me. I know there's a dungeon called the Chest, but I don't know if that's where I'm going. I don't know if this is somewhere else. Cathedral. Oh, damn, I have a completely different layout here, and I'm not really doing all that much damage. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's definitely nothing amazing. Yo, this soothing ass, like, I don't know how to describe it. It's very fitting for the location, though, the music. Oh, do I stomp shit? Yeah, I do. I'm gonna stomp on everything then, and I'm gonna spawn spiders that are gonna hurt me. Nope. Eh, it's not worth it. Ow. Okay. Fuck off. You lot bastards. Oh god, three of these dudes? Oh shit. Oh, that wasn't bad. Actually taking real damage now. Yay, more money that I don't really have anything to use on. Okay, I take it back. This version sucks. I have no real damage output. Explode. Jesus Christ. I'm just gonna lay a bomb and hope that shit works. Okay, good. Wonder why that one was just standing there the whole time. That was a little weird. Well, that one's useless too. I do not want that. I hate those whatever the fuck those are. They change, like, the trajectory of all your shots, so they make, like, that one would have made all my shots wavy, which makes them really fucking annoying to aim. There's another one that makes them go in kind of like a zigzag pattern. Basically, they're just all unnecessary and annoying, and they don't really do anything good. I guess in combination with certain things, like, if you had penetrative shots, so, like, those things would just be flying all over the damn place and hitting everything in the room, that'd be, oh, fuck this. And just hitting everything in the room, that'd be cool, but in general circumstances, that shit's useless. See, again, like, I'm late enough in the game now that I think, oh, I should be basically one-shotting these bastards. Nope. You don't have that kind of loadout right now. Shit. Worked out. Still didn't really do that much damage, though. It's taking me longer to kill this mini side boss than it is to get through an entire stage normally. Flaws of randomness. Oh dear god, whatever, I'll take it. I should not have taken it. I just realized I only have one. Oh god, I'm dead. I'm not getting through this one. I mean, normally this wouldn't be that big of an issue, but this loadout just sucks. I can't go back to that room. Like, I hope I don't have to go back through that room, because I will probably die. Fuck it. Oh, never mind. That did a lot of damage. I gotta watch. I can't walk back all the way, though. Noice. See, look at, like, it takes, like, three shots for his health bar to, like, decrease in any noticeable fashion. Yeah, that luck up. I've had all the luck in the world so far this run. Fuckers. You know, fucking, I'm gonna use Devil. I should've. What the hell did I hit? What did I hit? Like, none of them were around. Let me see, is there anything over here? What did I hit? Did I just not notice one? I guess I just didn't. Oh, maybe one of them shot me and I didn't see it. I guess that is a possibility. Oh my god. I gotta kill these things to get through here. Ah! Fuck, I'm not winning this. There's no way in hell I'm gonna get through this, okay? Especially because I've never fought this dude before, so I don't know what he's capable of. I don't know what he does. Oh my god! Yeah, there it is. See? I didn't even see what hit me. Obviously I got hit by a shot, but I didn't even see the come out. I guess that's... I shouldn't go that way, because it does give me a more limited view. Damn it, man! Like... 2 out of 4 runs. Very solid, very good, looking up, looking like I can actually make something with them, and then I get smacked in the face by randomness. Alright, well thank you for watching. Sorry it turned from fun to frustration. Hopefully we'll have better luck in the future.